Hey, I'm Vaughn.
And I'm Claire. This is Deconstructing IoT, where we build applications, break down concepts, and interview experts at the forefront of the Internet of Things.
Today we're talking about noise. Noise pollution can be pretty irritating in big cities, but there's evidence that it can be more than just a small annoyance.
Lifetime exposure to 85 decibels or higher, like that of a diesel truck, can actually lead to progressive hearing loss. Studies also show that it can lead to higher blood pressure and higher heart rate. And it's not just the immediate effect on our senses. Noise pollution can have negative effects on bird populations and can cause property values to drop.
What if noise information was available for members of neighborhood organizations to inform community planning decisions? And compare that noise level information with the number of bars and restaurants nearby. We're creating several audio sensor modules. Each has an Arduino Yún with a small microphone sensor. The Arduino will pick up the noise levels from the mic, and a simple web application allows users to check on one of the modules by clicking on a location on a map. The map uses our Google Geocoding Choreo to identify which of our noise sensing modules is closest to the location that's been clicked, and then we'll display the current noise levels for that module, along with information about the number of bars and restaurants nearby taken from the Yelp Choreo. Let's see how it works. We'll need one Arduino Yún, a sensor, in this case we have an Adafruit mic amp, and in order to install outside, you'll need some kind of enclosure to protect it.
Now that we have our noise sensing module, it's time to generate our code. Our Arduino Yún will send messages containing our noise level values into an Amazon SQS queue. Then it'll be available for request from our web application. On the Amazon SQS send message page, I'll turn on IoT mode and select the Arduino Yún as my board. I have my credentials saved into a profile. I'll be using a placeholder for the message body input because we'll be replacing that with our sensor value in the Arduino code. In this demonstration, we'll identify each noise sensing module and its queue name by the zip code of its physical address. This works since we're only working with a few modules. Now I'll scroll down, copy and paste my code into the Arduino IDE, and upload the code to my board. If I try it out, you can see that there's a success message and my data has been submitted to the queue. In our web application, we'll want a way to identify the closest module to our point of interest, retrieve the latest noise data, and the number of commercial bars and restaurants in the area. We'll use Google Geocoding to identify the address of the nearest noise sensing module. I'll turn IoT mode off and use placeholders for the latitude and longitude inputs to generate the code. For the final web application, you could use the points clicked on a map to retrieve latitude and longitude, then plug those into variables used for those choreo inputs. I'm going to use the Node.js SDK for this example, but you can use the JavaScript, PHP, Ruby, or whichever SDK you're most comfortable with. I'll copy the code into my text editor and save the file in the same folder that I have my Tembu Node.js SDK. Tembu's output filters allow me to easily retrieve the address and zip code without having to parse the data. The zip code will then be used as the queue name input in the SQS received message choreo, and the address will be used as the address input for the Yelp choreo. Next, I'll generate the code to retrieve the number of commercial places or bars and restaurants in the area using the Yelp SearchByAddress Choreo. Again, I have my credentials saved in a profile, so I'll just add those in and use a placeholder for the address, which will be replaced with a string variable that contains the address returned by Google Geocoding. Scroll down and select Node.js, then integrate the code into your script. Finally, we want to retrieve the data from our noise sensing module, which has been sent to an Amazon SQS queue. I'll go ahead to the SQS received message choreo. I have my credentials saved into a profile, so I'll set that and put a placeholder for the queue name, which we'll replace with a string holding the zip code returned by the Google Geocoding choreo. Then copy the code and integrate it into your existing script. Don't forget to replace the placeholder inputs with the string variables that you've set up to contain the zip code and address returned by the Google Geocoding choreo. Run your Node.js script in the terminal window and see the results. Now that you have all of the data, you can figure out how you'd like to display it in your web page.
That's all there is to it. This kind of application could be extended, for instance, using our Zillow Oreos to compare property values with noise levels, or using our data.gov Oreos to compare age demographics in neighborhoods with their noise levels.
Are you working on an application using Temu that you'd like to share with us? Or do you have an idea for an IoT solution that you want to see us build? Get in touch at hey@temu.com and let us know.